this video, we're talking about what it means for a curve to be differentiable. Well, any curve is differentiable wherever it's able to be differentiated. A more helpful definition would be that a curve is differentiable wherever you can find its derivative, meaning its slope at any given point. On this curve, for example, we can see that the curve's slope is defined at every point, so we can say that this curve is differentiable. But what about this curve? How would you determine the slope at this point? Or what about this point on this curve? Can you define the slope of the line tangent to this point on this curve? We can't find the derivative at any of these points, because we can't find the derivative at a discontinuity, like the point discontinuity in the first graph and the jump discontinuity in the third graph, and we can't find the derivative at a corner, like the corner we see in the second graph. Therefore, these are all examples of non-differentiable functions, because they all contain at least one point where we can't find the derivative of the function. And that brings up the point that there's a difference between differentiable at a specific point and differentiable everywhere. A function can only be differentiable everywhere if it's differentiable at every single point. That's why these singular points disqualify each function from being differentiable. But let's talk a little bit more about what it means for a function to be differentiable in general. The biggest thing that helps us out is determining whether or not a function is continuous. The rule is that if a function is differentiable, it must be continuous. To be continuous, remember, you must be able to draw the graph without lifting your pencil. This function is not continuous, and it makes sense that it wouldn't be differentiable, because you cannot find the derivative at this point. The function isn't defined there, so the slope definitely isn't defined. So, a curve is not differentiable wherever there's a discontinuity, such as a vertical asymptote, a hole, or a jump. We've just shown that if a function is differentiable everywhere, it implies that the function is also continuous everywhere. That's always true. But the opposite statement isn't necessarily true. Just because a function is continuous doesn't mean that the function is necessarily differentiable. It might be, but it might not be. Take a look at this curve, for example. It's continuous, but it isn't differentiable. There aren't any discontinuities, but the slope at this point isn't defined. This kind of point is called the corner, or the cusp, of a function, and any function that has one is automatically non-differentiable. Another way that a curve can be continuous but not differentiable is for it to have a slope so steep that it isn't able to be defined. If the tangent line is perfectly vertical, then differentiating at that point would be like trying to find the slope of a vertical line. Since the slope of a vertical line is undefined, a curve isn't differentiable at a vertical tangent line. In order to understand why a vertical tangent line means that the slope is not defined, recall the limit definition of the derivative, which says that the derivative of a function is the limit, as h goes to 0, of f of a plus h minus f of a divided by h. At a point on the graph with a vertical tangent, there is literally no change on the x-axis, so h, which represents horizontal change in the slope, would be equal to 0, which would make the denominator equal to 0. This causes the fraction to be undefined, so the curve is not differentiable. Sometimes a function is definitely non-differentiable, like this one, which has periodic discontinuities, but we can still say that it is differentiable at a few points, such as this point, and this one. We can even say that it's differentiable on an entire interval, as long as the function is continuous along that interval and the graph does not include any vertical tangents or cusps. We have to be careful when talking about these intervals and always define whether the endpoints of the interval are included in the differentiability we're testing. If we're including the endpoints of an interval, we call this a closed interval. But if the endpoints are not included, we call it an open interval. So if we look at this curve, we can see that it's differentiable between x equals 0 and x equals 4. If we say the curve is differentiable on the open interval, it means we know it's differentiable everywhere in the interval, but not necessarily at the endpoints. That's the case here. We can see that the curve is differentiable between 0 and 4, but the function isn't differentiable at the endpoints x equals 0 and x equals 4. So we'd want to say that this curve is differentiable on the open interval 0 to 4. If we say the curve is differentiable on the closed interval, it means we know it's differentiable everywhere in the interval and that we tested the endpoints and it's differentiable at both endpoints too. To summarize, we now know that a curve is differentiable when it's continuous with a defined slope at every point. So a curve without discontinuities, cusps, or vertical tangents is differentiable, which means we know for sure that we can find its first derivative. Let's summarize what we now know. If a curve is differentiable, all that means is that it can be differentiated, which means we can find its derivative. Only functions that are smooth and continuous are differentiable, which means a function won't be differentiable at holes, jumps, asymptotes, or corners. In order to be differentiable on the closed interval, the curve has to be differentiable everywhere in the interval, including at both endpoints of the interval.